Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to State of Emergency. We're live here tonight in Vancouver, British Columbia, for the last stop before we head to the land down under. Still to come tonight, we have the UNIFY World Tag Team Championship Tournament, which will begin here tonight, where a debuting tag team will face off against Dylan Bryan Harrison and a partner of his choosing to kick things off in the tournament. Also to come tonight, the semifinals of what has now been announced as the Internet Championship Tournament. Brett Curtis will take on Mike Angel in singles action. Who will prevail and head to No Gods, No Masters in Auckland? And your main event of the evening, where the loser vacates their championship, Shane Sabin will take on Stalker, champion versus champion. It comes to a head here tonight in the main event of State of Emergency. However, kicking things off this evening is a semi-final match in the Internet Championship Tournament, and it is scheduled for one fall. Following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, Sean Parker. Sean Parker making his way to the ring for a semi-final match. This man returned to UNIFY at the beginning of the tournament and has been ruthless ever since. And just imagine if you are Sean Parker in his position right now, picking up a win here tonight against Fletcher Benson here in the semifinals. Puts you up against either Mike Angel or Brett Curtis at No Gods, No Masters for the Internet Championship. When this man left UNIFY, he was the number one contender, if my memory serves me right, for the Undisputed Championship. Upon departure, upon re-arriving, has found himself in Internet Championship contention. And his opponent he is the technical Aussie, Fletcher Benson. And this is a young man who a lot of people have been rooting for in this tournament. Fletcher Benson, a man who is a former Engage Pro Wrestling European champion. That's a little bit of a throwback, but Benson has gone for years in UNIFY without championship gold around his waist. Can he find his way to the finals here tonight? As the crowd here in Vancouver seem to be on mixed reactions and terms here with Fletcher Benson as he's in the ring currently. And we are ready. Sean Parker, Fletcher Benson. The first of the two semifinals as the bell sounds and we're underway. As Benson shot to the midsection, kicking things off here, but Parker gonna throw him back here. Ooh, Benson got a quick jab into the abdomen of forearm there by Parker. Kicked away there by Benson. Now looking to follow up with a forearm, jawboard English. Jawbreaker there by Benson now, sending him over into the corner. Charging with a drop kick and no one's home as things are already 100 miles an hour and the bell just rung a few seconds ago. Misses the stomp there as Sean looking for that crash landing. Connecting! Misses the kick to the back there now as Benson turned around. Shot to the back there by Barker. Trying to get any bit of offensive in that he can here. And a breakdown for this contest. Parker has the power advantage. Benson has the speed. If you're Fletcher Benson, the only thing I can recommend here will be to wear out Sean Parker. Physically exhaust the man before capitalizing on the opportunity present. Big nasty lariat there by Parker, taking Benson down to the canvas now. Shot to the midsection. Could have been looking for that ragdoll maneuver that he's been using as of late. Triangle choke here by Benson. Submission hold is locked in, but does he have it fully? No. As Parker just pummels Benson's face into a pulp there. Float over, possibly looking for a power slam. And that's him by the throat, looking to throw him here. And Benson again one step ahead of Parker. This is a shot. Ooh, a nasty grazing dropkick there by Benson. As he's starting to slow things down and starting to dissect Sean Parker here. As Benson now lining up his shot dead center of the ring. Parker's in a bad way early. Hammerlock in the lair. Down to the cover hook of the outside leg. Two and an air fall. Benson with an air fall off of that wrist-clutched lariat. Which has brought him to the dance here tonight. Between that and his double foot stomps is what's brought him all the way here to the semifinals. Benson brings the arm here and he's going to use the momentum against Parker there. Driving him neck first back into the canvas. Getting back up now. Beautifully done on the back body drop there by Parker. Getting what he can in when he can. And it's a clothesline. While stopping his tracks for the moment there by Benson. As he's slowly picking up steam. And there's the double foot stomp. Right across the shoulder blades. Nasty back elbow there as Parker again going to look for the crash landing. No, holds on to him. Ooh. A nasty neck breaker and Parker's starting to feel himself here. In the opening contest here, a state of emergency. A second shoulder check. Sends him into the corner. High speed in on the corner. Hits the ropes. And there's a spear to follow it up. As Parker slowly building up his head of steam. And again, Benson shuts him down in his tracks. Benson again looking possibly for the wrist clutch lariat here. But this time, Sean was able to get out of the way looking. German suplex dead center of the ring. Dumped him on his neck and only good for the one count. As Sean was looking for that torture rack sidewalk slam. And no one's home, misses the dropkick wildly there. And an overhand left there by Benson. As OO tilt whirl in the arm block. As Parker now depositing him over into the corner, shot to the back of the neck here. He's gonna just drag him up by his hair and release him down onto the canvas. Up and down again there. And third time's the charm. As Sean just in control here. He's manhandling Benson. As Benson gets him up here to the vertical base, he'll send him into the corner. Charging in. And oh, wait a minute. Strong sends him into the other corner. Benson flip over, duck the line. Follow up, big elbow. Big elbow there by Fletcher Benson. As he's picking up momentum, he's building up steam here. He's got him up. Oh, wait a minute, wait. Sean counters, tombstone pile driver. Tombstone pile driver is Benson crawling into the corner. He was looking for a variation of his own, but was caught off guard there by Sean Parker. I didn't even know he knew how to do a tombstone pile driver. Shots the midsection. As Sean now lining up the shot here, he's looking for that torture rack sidewalk slam that we've seen him do in weeks past, and there it is! As he'll drag him out of the corner, down to the cover, and that's it. That's ball game. 2-0. Fletcher found a way to get the shoulder up for there. Just a brief second here. Jawbreaker is now, sending Sean again wrist first into the canvas. And he'll get him up to the vertical base. Work that arm again. Repeatedly working on that arm is Benson. He's been doing it all match. Rolls him over here, has him in that high angle cloverleaf into a backstabber. As Benson thinks that's going to be enough down to the cover off of that cloverleaf backstabber too. And a near fall. Near fall after near fall here in the semifinals of the Internet Championship Tournament. Missing the big boot wildly there is Parker. And he meets with that backbreaker. And again, the one stop from Benson. And you could tell Fletcher Benson is exhausted as Parker beginning the star kick to the back of the head. And another one for good measure into the Dragon Sleeper. It's a submission hold, and he's got him locked in deep. Ooh, double knees there by Sean to break out of the submission hold there, sending him into the corner. And again, Benson collapses. And a shot to the midsection. And oh, looking for the power bomb. But Benson fights out of the power bomb. Oh, he's got a front chancery. Front chancery, Parker buying himself some time there. But gets met with a form and a kick to the ribs. European uppercut. And off the ropes, here we go, Benson. Atomic drop. And down goes Parker. And a third time with the foot stomp. Benson this time goes for the cover. Third foot stomp in succession two. And an earfall. A near fall sweep of the leg there by Parker. As he's just trying to find anything that he can. One in the kitchen sink, and he got caught and countered there. As, oh, big clothesline again there from Benson. As Sean shoulder checking him down. The clothesline now sending him up into ringside. As Fletcher Benson gets thrown right back in there by Sean Parker as he's trying to unload, trying to get the ball rolling again. Overhand right jab block form there by Benson. Kick blocked there by Parker. Nasty big boot there by Sean Parker. It staggered Benson all the way to the outside of the ring. Where Parker will join him full on. Kick blocked there by Parker. Who sends him back into the ring here. Benson is already up on his vertical base right hand. And oh, wait a minute. Ooh, a modified version of the Olympic slam. Down to the cover. Hook of the outside right one. Two, near four. Another near fall. Jawbreaker there by Benson. charging in, possibly looking for the foot stomp again. No one home that time. Right hand, right hand, right hand. He's up on his shoulders into the sidewalk stomp again. And that's gotta be it. It's gotta be a 1-2 in a near fall. Still not enough. This is the stomp there as old Benson. Wise missing the big boot is Parker. This is aggression. Got the best of it into the backbreaker there by Benson as he's lining up his shot here. One more time. Is it going to be enough? Wrist clutched lands to the cover. Hook to the outside line. 1-2 and no. Another near fall. As Benson wasting no time, going right back to work on the arms. Ooh. And Benson backing it up again. Backing it up again. Tilt a whirl. Into the arm bar. It's dead center of the ring. But Sean's able to get out of it for the moment. Big left hand there by Benson. Shot to the midsection. Oh, look at her DDT. He's caught the counter into the flat iron. Beautifully done on the reversal there by Benson. With that flatliner looking for something that got caught with a forearm. Big boot again sidestepped. Is Benson a form to the back? Backbreaker lariat. Beautifully done on the combination from Benson. The backbreaker lariat combination. 1-2. And that is gonna do it. As Fletcher Benson will meet the winner of Mike Angel and Brett Curtis at the main event of No Gods, No Masters. I'm gonna purchase some things that I know will not fill my needs. If it does what I achieve, then get lonesome and I critique who I am and what I believe. Make up standards too high to reach. I'm trained in, I'm the law, at least I'm in panic. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the belt and advancing to the finals, Fletcher Benson. Fletcher Benson has found his way to the finals.
Cause I-
big thank you to Cutthroat Wrestling as we look forward to seeing what they produce here in the coming months on the Wrestling Network. However, the following contest is a tag team match. Skinner for one fall. And it is round one in the winner's bracket of the World's Tag Team Championship Tournament. Introducing first, the Canadian Connection. As ladies and gentlemen, the Tag Team Championship Tournament begins here in mere moments. As we all know, the tag team titles were vacated after Manifest. And we'll find out who exactly is going to be the new tag team champions. Now, you heard me make mention of it moments ago that this is round one of the winner's bracket of the tournament. Which, for anyone who knows how that style of tournament works, it is dual elimination. A loss in the winner's bracket and a loss in the loser's bracket will eliminate the team from the tournament. And in the finals will be the winner of the loser's bracket versus the winner of the winner's bracket for the World's Tag Team Championships. Introducing their opponents first, Dylan Bryan Harrison. Dylan Bryan Harrison makes his way to the ring with a massive opportunity on his platter here. A win here will advance them on in the tournament bracket and one step closer to Dylan Bryan Harrison's first piece of gold here in UNIFY. And introducing his tag team partner, hailing from the Isles of Jamaica, Chuck Courtney. Chuck Courtney, for those of you who have been around a while, will know that this man has made a little bit of an impact here in UNIFY over the past 6 months, making his debut in the 2021 No Regrets Rumble, and he lasted a decent bit before being eliminated by this year's winner, Lance Romance, who no longer is with us in UNIFY. We wish him well in whatever he may be doing elsewhere. Courtney slowly pacing his way to the ring. And you can feel it in the atmosphere. It's a tangible, almost electric feeling. Here in Vancouver. A feeling, dare I say, of rebirth and revived life. As these two men kick off something that could definitely reshape the world's tag team division. As the bell sounds and we are underway here, as starting things off for the Canadian Connection is Brandon Gunn taking on Dylan Bryan Harrison to kick things off from each respective team. Out of the corner, Tornado DDT there by Harrison. One in the shot. Ooh, big forearm shot to midsection. And he's going to follow up. Big neck breaker. Very well done. As DBH was looking for a power slam, and Gunn caught him on a flying fish elbow. As a jawbreaker there, staggers Gunn backwards for a moment. Big stun gun. And a shot to the forehead here. As, ooh, Gunn already going for a cross face. But the referee told him to break it. And indeed he did. Jawbreaker there by Harrison. As an arm drags, or a Irish whip sends him into the corner. Big kick there by Gunn. My word, it's been a minute since I called a tag team match. Kicking him away now is Gunn trying to follow it up here. Big Irish whip sending him back into the corner of Canadian Connection. Charging in, misses the crossbody to the abdomen. As Harrison will grab him by the back of the neck here and try and escort him back to the corner of his team. But to no avail. Collar and elbow shot to the midsection there. As Gunn now cradles him, has him hammer lock. Big suplex. As Gunn may be looking to make a tag here to his tag team partner, Troy Winters, who's standing on the apron here. The other member of the Canadian Connection, beautifully done on the Northern Lights there by Gunn into the brainbuster. And what a way to follow through with it. As Gunn now going to back this up and, ooh. Gunn looking for something here, and Bryan Harrison is not stirring whatsoever. He's on his knees. Misses a kick there. Oh, schoolboy. Schoolboy there by Harrison. Down to the cover, and it's a non-contested count by our senior official. Rolling through now is Gunn. One in the forearm. It's blocked there now by Harrison. Sends him off the ropes. One in the kick there. No one home. Out of the corner. A second tornado DDT there by DBH. As he'll set him up here and begin to work on the hamstring. On the right leg there of Brandon Gunn, a schoolboy of his own, just to release the submission hold. Shot to the midsection there. Armbringer looking for a possible cutter. Gunn caught him. Sends him into the corner there with Troy Winters, Canadian Connection. Oh no, Winters not wanting the tag there. Giving Gunn his space. As Gunn already. We're not even 3 minutes into this match, Brandon. From corner to corner, coast to coast. Brandon Gunn busts out the coast to coast. Drags him near center of the ring. Shoots the half hook to the outside leg. One, two in the near fall. As Gunn now, bow and arrow, submission hold, a modified rendition of a surfboard. That bow and arrow locked in deep here on Dylan Bryan Harrison. My word, too many DBs and H's and G's in the ring currently. And a big rising knee there by DBH. As he's lining up his shot here, Gunn gets caught, shot to the knee, into that big shining wizard. Down to the cover, hook of the outside leg. DBH down to the cover too, and a near fall. As DBH now spin kick to the abdomen, hits him off the ropes, single leg drop kick. Run up another single leg, he'll load it, duck it here into that swinging neck breaker. It's Vince Harrison. Gunn rolls through, gets caught with a punch, kick to the leg there by Gunn, looking for something there, big clothesline there by DDH, as both men trading nuclear warheads here, in the right hand and left, ooh, gun, a ring veteran. He's been going for, dare I say, going on a better half of a decade of in-ring action. Down to the cover, is only good for a one count. As it was broken up there by Jake Courtney, as Troy Winters is in the ring. For just a brief moment, looking for the underhook face plant, and Gunn, knowing very much where he is, sent him down. Jake Courtney, now the legal man for their respective team, and there's a big boot, and a second one to the abdomen of Gunn. Third time's the charm. And there's the tag, and in comes Troy. And a big boot of his own. And a second one, and he's returning the favor now. Jake Courtney knew where he's going. Irish Whip setting him off with ropes here, looking for something, and there's a clubbing blow to the back. Right hand is blocked. Jake Courtney with the double leg. And he'll fire off a few shots in the skull there. As Jake Courtney laying in the boots here. Oh, got caught. And Troy on an exploder. As he's looking to line him up here. Deadlift. And the power of this man into the power bomb. Getting him up here. And ooh, knee to the midsection. Midsection discus, Larry. Discus Lariat, but a shoulder check there by Courtney. Ooh, nasty right hand behind back elbows. We create a little bit of separation here. Oh, geez. Troy with the power. Overhead release, belly to belly suplex. It has launched him like it was nothing. Bell clap there by Troy, who sends us back into the corner. As there's the tag. Brandon Gunn, the legal man, double. And it's spinebuster and a frog splash. Down to the cover two and a near fall. As the referee counting in Troy Winters now. As Gunn eats the top turnbuckle. Into the corner, it goes into the corner where normally Dylan Bryan Harrison would be, but there's nowhere to be found for the moment. Arm drag bringing him down now as Gunn ducks and gets caught with a right. He catches the foot here, a German suplex from Gunn. As wait a minute. Courtney brings him back in with a beautiful hip toss. As Gunn now bringing him into the corner. But a big back elbow there by Jake Courtney creates a little bit of separation. Was looking for a spine buster, got turned around into a bulldog there by Gunn. And deadlift. Gut wrenched. Power bomb. Down to the cover one. Two near four. Gunn wasting no time, getting right back to it, but Jake Courtney has recovered just enough to counter. Right hand block with a forearm there by Gunn. Back into the ring now. Fireman's carry counter there by Jake Courtney. As Gunn in a bad way, looking for the body slam, got caught in counter reverse DDT from Gunn. As Brandon now just stomping a hole into the side of Jake Courtney's skull and another gut-wrench powerbomb. A second gut-wrench, and he'll send us back into the corner with Troy. Tag in comes Winters. Spinebuster. Frog splash a second time. Down to the cover one, two, and an air fall. And oh! Jacoby sends this to ringside. Referee count three. An 08 minute DDT from Jacoby on the floor. No, blocked there by Troy Winter. Kind of a tie up, throwing him down here. Count of six. Both these men need to get back in the ring, and Winters will send Cordy back into the ring. Shot to the back of the leg there. Overhand right to the back. And a high back elbow to create some distance. Sends him back into the corner there. And oh, misses the splash wildly. As there's a little less press at Jacoby laying in those punches. Big European there by Troy, wanting a right hand, blocked with a forearm there by Cordy. Down to the Irish whip, sends him up and over to the apron here, looking for the belly-to-belly suplex. And a shot to the back there. Getting up counter, the Irish whip sending him into the corner there. Jamaican sensation super kick there from Jacoby. And it's only good for a two count. And Jacoby's fired up here. As he hit that devastating super kick. But Winters was looking for something in the eyes of right there by Jacoby. Who will send this into the corner here. Standing switch there. And a back elbow would get him out of the situation there as Jacoby. And ooh, STO. As he's going to back it up here. He's going to look for another one. Winding up. Connects with another Jamaican sensation. Super kick dead center of the ring. Down to the cover. One, two, in the near fall. A near fall as Troy Winters. Oh dear, and he launched him again. Just launched him again. My word. As Winters still the Leo man, and he's going to work here on the knees of Jacoby here, just wrenching on him. And just dropping the knees into the groin there. Referee, blind as ever, did not call for the bell. But Jacoby going to disengage here and tag in Dylan Bryan Harrison. As Troy Winters yet to tag back in Brandon Gunn. As the combination flurry from Harrison. Rolling through as, oh, wait a minute. Winters launches him. Winters launched right to ringside. As DBH with a shot to the back of the leg there, blocking the forearm now. Looking right, and it's blocked. Form there by Harrison, who brings this back into the ring here. Referee count of three. It shot to midsection, shot to the midsection, and twist of fate. And indeed, a drastic twist of fate it was. However, Winters looking for it again. This time he gets caught with an elbow. Wanting a knee, it was blocked. And again, this time launching Harrison. As Troy Winters has brought his power into this one. Sweep of the leg. And oh, handspring misses the back elbow wildly. Has him up to the vertical base now. Big clothesline. And here comes Troy Winters. Back
body drop. It is Big Man's about to follow out. Spine Buster.
This is a knee kick to the back. Getting him up now is Harrison, who will send him into the corner here. Charging. Ooh, double knees. We're blocked again, this time by Winners. Irishrip now sending him into the corner, looking for something big. Slow walk in, but kicked away there by DB. Kick to the back of the leg. Oh, he misses wildly on that forearm. Wanting that super kick to the knee, look for that Shining Wizard, sends him off the ropes, both men collide. Calling up a tie-up shot to the midsection there by Harrison. Oh, was looking for possibly an STO, was blocked there by Winners. We'll send it back into the corner there. Tag, in comes Gunn. Has him up, all right, into the suplex and a drop kick. Apollo down. As Gunn sends him into the corner, again, this is that cross body. Sends him back into the corner. Tag, back in comes Winners. Spine Buster from Gunn. Frog splash from Winners. Down to the cover, look at the outside on two. And again, the roof. Canadian Connection have hit their best move three times in succession here. We've yet to be able to put him away. Another exploder. As an Irish whip sending Troy to the apron here. As DBH light him up with a few shots there. What could he be thinking here? Big drive by. Apology fair for back here on commentary. Big form there now. Andre bringing him down as Winners, wanting the clothesline to dump him to ringside. No one was home. Big shot to the back of the skull now as DBH. Big high knee. As and there's the tag. In comes Gunn. As DBH vacated the ring a moment ago. Big drop kick to the back of the head. Oh, DBH is packed to his feet. Oh! He planted a gun. Bleeding all over the new canvas. Oh, I hope that had a clean two. Three. And the team of DBH and Jacourney pick up the victory. Sending Canadian Connection to the loser's bracket. And what a match. What a man. Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the bout, and advancing to the next round, the team of Jacourney and Dylan Brian Harrison. What a match. Kill you, something else.
Big thank you to Honor Wrestling for the respect to the game. Soon moves here soon. The following contest is the final semi-final match. The internet champion tournament set for one goal. Introducing first. This man needs no introduction. Former UNIFY World Heavyweight Champion, former two-time World Champion, a former World Tag Team Champion. But one thing he is not for is the NXT Championship. Curtis is ready, but introducing his opponent. He is the sus god, Mike Angel. Mike Angel on his way to the ring, and this man, some would say, has become the nearly man of UNIFY. Where time and time again, he comes so close, but can't get past a certain stage. And truly what is going to be a make or break moment for Mike Angel when it comes to the Internet Championship Division. As we are ready, as we're underway here, bell sounds as Mike and Curtis go head to head. And ladies and gentlemen, please do not forget your main event this evening. Coming up next, Stalker Shane Saban loser relinquishes their championship. It comes to a head for them in the main event this evening at State of Emergency. And what a night it's been so far, where we saw the team of Dylan Bryan Harrison just moments ago and Jacourtney advance in the winner's bracket while sending Canadian Connection to the loser's bracket. And we also have seen tonight Fletcher Benson punch his ticket to send himself to No Gods, No Masters for the Internet Championship. And right after No Gods, No Masters, ladies and gentlemen, will be Final Chapter in Sydney, Australia on pay-per-view, where should Stalkers escape the main event this evening, will be defending the World's Heavyweight Championship in his own home country. Where, if I remember correctly, it'll be the first time
the World's Heavyweight Championship had been defended in the Land Down Under. Beautifully done in these standing switches, by the way, between Curtis and Mike Angel. Angel now kicking him away. Kick to the midsection there by Curtis. And shot to midsection. Oh dear. That's a bad place to be. And Mike knew exactly where that was. Knew exactly what was coming. Big close line. No! It tossed into a neck breaker. As Mike now lining up his shot, lining up for the Zeiss event, looking for that vintage headlock driver. Lance Curtis with the referee calls for the ropes. You see, Mike was a little confused and a little distraught there. Wind up elbow. European uppercut there by Curtis. High rake there, getting some separation, single leg drop kick, no. And that is the mean streak of Curtis. That was on display there. That penalty kick to the gut there, Irish Whip sending him off the ropes. Mike Bookman collide. Grabs him up in the front chancery now, looking for something big. Holding on to that front chancery, separation is created. Spin kick to the abdomen, creates a little bit of an opening there. Right hand there by Curtis. Follow through Larry, and no. Ooh, flying back up all the way. Angel's back up on his feet. As he's going to just brutalize Curtis here. And a shot across the jawline gets him down. Hammerlock is applied. And watch this here. Wrenching on the wrist and the fingers before releasing it all and driving his knees into the exposed spine. As wheelbarrowing him up into the neck breaker. Also, apologize for any background noises. Well, brothers and four brothers. Beautifully done on the flatliner there by Curtis. As he waits for him to get back up, shots of the midsection. We're after the flatliner. Spike pile driver. Spike pile driver, Curtis giving no leniency, no mercy. Form into the pump and the flatliner. Down to the cover. Two. And a new call. A near fall. Flatliner. Spike pile driver. Pump handle flatliner. And it still wasn't enough. Clothesline. A second one from Curtis. Ducks the line. A thrust kick. Trying to find anything whatsoever they can do. Going for a second with a little bit more emphasis on the spike pile driver. Spike pile driver, second time form. Pump handle, flat liner. Cover again, one, two, and another near fall. And Curtis can't believe it. Shot to the midsection. And so, Hangman's DDT there from Curtis. Rolling through now. And both men were looking for a forearm, but Curtis got his in first. Looking for something there, but dropped him back over the top rope. Dragon Rush on the floor. Devastating Dragon Rush on the floor. And Curtis. Arm wringer drops the arm over the shoulder. Big forearm there. Right back. And Mike, DDT! Scoots to the cover. And again, the referee calls the ropes. As beautifully done on the back of it, a little bust open Mike there for a moment. Bit of nasty forearm right back there as he gets taken down to the canvas. My big swing in that breaker plants Curtis. And he's just trying to find anything here. Beautifully done on the back body drop. As Curtis, he knows exactly what he's doing. Going after... Oh, double leg spinebuster! As Mike Angel's starting to fire up here right hand. A devastating right hand as Curtis sends him in. Charges in the face first. Here comes Mike. Counter the Irish Whip. Beautifully done on the face breaker. But Curtis fires a punch right back. Four. Alternating four. And that one got caught with a side thrust kick. Spin kick out of it there. And nasty form again there by Angel. As Mike is lining up his shot here, he's looking for the knee. Connect. That's seven. Cover. Referee's in position. One. Two. Near fall. A near fall there is Curtis. Big close on. And again, Mike kicks him away. It is back and forth here, and Mike is having the time of his life, but he also knows what's on the line here. A shot to be a first. A chance to be the first internet champion. Curtis, Curtis. So I thought, pump handle variation wasn't doing the job. Went for the jumping variation of the flatliner. And Nolan is home. There it is. Jumping flatliner. Down to the cover. Hook in the outside leg. And another near fall. And Curtis is in a state of English disbelief. As, Mike, DDT again. DDT out of nowhere. One, two, and in there, four. That's a beautiful shoulder check. And a jawbreaker there from Angel. Running the knees again. Curtis sidestep. He's caught with a jab. Caught with a lariat there. It's Curtis. Slowly rebuilds momentum here, reminding the crowd he always has a game plan. Misses the punch. Oh, right hand. Pump handle into the rope. Flatline. Cover. Wait. Mike's hands are under the ropes. But the referee, not seeing it, spelt the bitter end for Mike Angel in this tournament. But the crowd here in Vancouver saw it just like you all did. Controversy surrounds Curtis's victory. But nonetheless, he advances to the final. Hardcore Pro. I believe they had an episode that recently went out as well. Be sure to go check them out. But nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, you made it. The following contest is the main event of the evening, and it is a dual championship bout scheduled for one fall with TV time remaining. Introducing first, he is the UNIFY Undisputed World's Heavyweight Champion. Main event, Stalker. And the boyhood dream of Stalker can come to an end here tonight. The title reign can come to an end before he can make it home. The question is, will he be able to knock off Shane here tonight? The champion who's been on a warpath. His opponent, he is the unified world's middleweight champion, Shane Sabin. If you've been a long time viewer of UNIFY, you'll know exactly who this man is and why he's so dangerous. Two-time UNIFY World Heavyweight Champion. One-time Engage Pro Wrestling World Heavyweight Champion. One-time PLW World Heavyweight Champion. Two-time Origins Champion. Two-time and current World Middleweight Champion. And there is plenty more accolades on that banner. Shane looks point blank and simple, ready to end a title reign that he could potentially find himself in a predicament where he could win the title back and become a three-time World Heavyweight Champion. But nonetheless, the bell sounds. We are underway. Main event of the evening. Where is champion versus champion? Will Nelson there by Shane, and he'll fire off a reverse DDT. First proper maneuver of this contest here, as there's a nasty shoulder check there by Stalker. Big kick to the back. It's missed there. As Shane looking to unload, as both of these men picking up steam. And Shane wants to end this early. Wanting a cutter blocked. Ooh, penalty kick, but he stays standing. Block of the cutter there. As Stalker charging in bicycle knee. Blocked there by Sabin, who sends over onto the ropes. Irish Whip sends him off. Drop down there from Sabin. Ooh, wanting a drop kick. No one home overhand. Right block with one of his own there by Shane. Penalty kick this time. Takes out the knees as he'll pick him up. One per center, dead center. As Shane and Stalker going back and forth here. Headbutt. And oh, wait a minute. Stalker looking for a brainbuster. It's blocked there by Shane. And a flying elbow, but Stalker stays standing. Spin kick, no. Oh. Northern Lights. And he'll float over. This time he'll get it. Spinning brainbuster. As I'll get him up. Big European uppercut. A shot to the midsection there. As Stalker now in control here. As he flings Shane off the ropes there. Sending him down into the middle of the ring. Referee in position. Down to the cover one. It's only good for one there for Stalker. And a big drop kick to the shoulder blades. As, a high knee there by Saban. As both men slowly starting to slow things down. Butterfly clutch there by Saban looking for the DDT, but arm drag out of it there. As Stalker could have been looking for that running blockbuster. As Stalker awaits Saban, who just found his way to the vertical base in the corner. And Stalker turn, buckle powerbomb. The turnbuckle powerbomb. As Stalker looking for it. Shots in midsection. And Saban says, I used to do that myself, kid. As he was looking for that powerbomb into the lung blower, Shane is stalking him. And nasty super kick there from the world's middleweight champion. Will it end the reign of main event Stalker? 1, 2, near fall. A near fall. As Shane tried to get him back up, back body drop there by Stalker. And a back body drop sends one right back. Up to the vertical base now, in a knee there by Stalker. Finds himself a moment. He's looking for something when it's thrown face first into the canvas. Kick to the back there. And a back body drop for his troubles. Shoulder check there by Saban. And another shoulder check. And this is vintage from the world's middleweight champion. Top rope. Double axe handle. As Shane wasting no time going right back. As he smells the blood in the water. Blood in the water. Burning hammer. Headlock here as Shane just starting to slow things down, hoping that Stalker will just pass out. Burning hammered down right on the top of his skull, and followed up now with that modified rendition of a sleeper hold. Shane wasting no time here, lining up the shot again, a super kick. Again, replay the footage down to the cover. 1, 2, and again near fall. As wait a minute, Stalker! Stalker's gotten deep into a submission hold! Deep into a submission hold! But, a knee to the back of the head and a right! Breaks him free, charging in. Dunk there by Stalker! As Shane was looking for a flying elbow there. As he got thrown off the hard way there by the world's heavyweight champion. And Stalker is just doing that. Stalking. Shane Saban here misses the penalty kick. Rolling through now, misses the high knee. Wanting something there, but a forearm there by Saban stops him in his tracks. Looking for the follow up there on a belly to belly, but big right hands there by Stalker will create the separation. As we're sending him off the ropes here. Oh, running and there's a shot to the abdomen. As Stalker gets kicked off there by Shane Sabin, who's looking to pick him up now. Elbows to the abdomen. Charging in another knee this time. Sabin does go down. And shots to the abdomen again there in another form. As Stalker now again kicked away there by Sabin, who's daring him to bring it. As, that was a bad call there. As Stalker and the Brainbuster. Stalker finally found the Brainbuster. As Sabin sets him up and over to the apron right hand. A right hand here and a stunner on the middle rope. As we'll send the world's heavyweight champion ringside, as the world middleweight champion is in control. Shots in the section again here, and it's very much back and forth. Referee's count is of three or four. Sends him face first onto the barricade. Count of five. Both men create separation. Spin kick to the abdomen. The count of six. As Shane fires back here against Stalker. Count of seven. And Stalker enters the ring and awaits Shane. Shane reminding him exactly what's on the line. What's at stake here. One block with a sidekick there by Stalker, caught him in a stun gun. As Shane again, full Nelson turnaround DDT. And both of these men are exhausted. Not exactly sure how much either one of these two has left in the tank. Big spinning leg lariat there by Shane, who's got to dig deep here. Referee count of five. Shot to the midsection there by Sabin. Spin kick, no. Sending him in the ring. As Stalker gets Shane right up. Drop kick, swatted away, roll through. Big knee. And it'll send Shane enziguri him to the side of the head while he's trying to get up. And again the submission hold. Again the submission hold. Stalker has it deep. But again he's able to pry it out of it. The knee there from Stalker. Come on. Something that Stalker has been doing a lot as of late, the out of nowhere knee strike. It's helped him retain the world's championship many of occasions. A second dosage on the knee, down to the corner. One, two, three. And it looks like that final chapter, the vacancy of the World Middleweight Championship, will be filled. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the bout, and still, UNIFY Undisputed World Champion, Stalker. But we're out of time. We'll see you next time.